हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेरी वेल वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन इन दिस लेक्चर ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर आर्किटेक्चर एंड पैटर्न डिज़ाइन। हियर वी हैव टू सी टूवर्ड्स द फ्यू पॉइंट्स। फर्स्ट वन इज दैट वी हैव टू लुक टूवर्ड्स द इंट्रोडक्शन एंड वोकैबुलरी principles of design, then software modeling, in that there is a modeling structure and a modeling behavior. After that we have to look towards design pattern, then in that design pattern there is a architecture pattern, that is the layer architecture, pipe filter or a model view controller. Then design pattern, within that we have to see towards the strategy of design pattern, observer, state, mediator, then the what is single turn, memento or inversion of control, then libraries and framework of this. After that quality criteria in architecture. So we have to move towards everything one by one. So we know that over a decades of software engineering, many clever and proved and tested designs of solution for particular problem are more emerged there. But here the question we can generalize, document and reuse these designs is the major question. So there are few goals related to it. Don't reinvent the wheel. That is, benefit from clever, from proven and from tested and from solution, that is the architecture pattern. An architecture pattern express a fundamental structural organization schema for a software system. It provides the setup, predefined subsystems, specifies their responsibilities and includes rules and guidelines for organizing the relationships between them. For that there is a layered architecture there. We are too much familiar with the concept of layered architecture because in our graduation level we have seen the different types of models in software engineering, like there is a waterfall, spiral and more. Also in computer networking there are few models which are we have seen, that is ISO OSI model, then TCP/IP model. So we are familiar with the concept of layered technology. So today as example we have to discuss about there is a ISO OSI reference model. It will shows how the structured layered architectures are work. ISO stands for International Standard Organizations and OSI stands for Open System Interconnection. So that is ISO OSI reference model. Within this model there are 7 number of layers there. First layer is physical layer, second one is that the data link layer, third one is that the network layer, fourth one is the transport layer, fifth one is the session layer, sixth one is presentation layer, and the last layer, that is the application layer. If we see towards this model, there is a layer whose components only interact with components of their direct neighbor layers. That is called protocol-based layer. And protocol-based layer hides all layers beneath it and defines a protocol which is only used by layers directly, as shown in figure. So this example of layered architecture can't do, that is object oriented layer that interacts with layer directly and possibly further above and below also. For that, there is a rules components of layer may use only components of protocol based layer directly beneath, or all component of layer further beneath, as shown in figure. Suppose this layer interact with layer directly and possibly further above and below, there is a components of layer may use directly, as shown in figure. Then this, after this, there is a three tier architecture we have to see. We are too much familiar with the concept of tiered architecture. We know that presentation layer or the tier, it is the user interface that present the information obtained from the logic layer to the user, controls interaction with the user, that is requests action at the logic layer according to user's input. Logic layer core system functionality layer designed without information about presentation layer may only read or write data according to the data layer interface. The data layer is the persistent data storage, hides the information about how data is organized, read and return, offers particularly chunks of information in form useful for the logic layer, as shown in figure. The best example of this architecture is a web shop, then the business software, that is the enterprise resource planning ERP is there. So friends, today I hope that you have understand the concept of this layered architecture. It will definitely helpful for us whenever to design the software architecture. So thank you so much to everyone. Thank you.